are fully prepared to defeat Indian designs. Any miscalculation will result in global embarrassment for India as it faced in the year 2019. It is reiterated that if any ill-considered misadventure is resorted to by India, it will face an assured notch-up military response from Pakistan. Such a scenario will, however, seriously destabilize the region with catastrophic consequences. This has also been shared with important world capitals. Any military conflict between Pakistan and India will also seriously undermine the peace prospects in Afghanistan, for which the entire responsibility will rest with India. Pakistan urges the international community to advise India against any irresponsible act and to desist from any action that would jeopardize regional peace and stability. We also want the Indian political and military leadership to know that their mindset and sinister designs are well known to us. Our valiant armed forces stand ready to respond forcefully and effectively. In the interest of regional peace and stability, India would be well advised to desist from any misadventure. Separately, Pakistan strongly condemns the continuing ceasefire violations by India in clear violation of international law, the 2003 ceasefire understanding, and against all established humanitarian norms and professional military conduct. This morning, at around 10:45 hours, Indian occupation forces in Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir resorted to unprovoked firing in Chirikot sector of the line of control. The Indian troops specifically targeted a United Nations vehicle carrying two officers of the United Nations Military Observer Group in India and Pakistan. The officers were on their way to Polas village to meet with the victims of the Indian ceasefire violations. The UN vehicle was damaged. Fortunately, the officers were not injured. The officers were immediately evacuated by Pakistan Army and brought back to the Unmogib field station in Rawalkot. The reprehensible act of unprovoked firing by India on the Unmogib officers is indicative of a new low in the conduct of Indian occupation troops. This year alone, India has committed 2,992 ceasefire violations to date, resulting in 27 shahadas and serious injuries to 249 innocent civilians, including 92 women and 68 children. Pakistan calls upon India to respect the 2003 ceasefire understanding, investigate such incidents of deliberate ceasefire violations, and maintain peace along the line of control and the working boundary. Pakistan also urges India to allow the United Nations Military Observer Group in India and Pakistan to play its mandated role as per the United Nations Security Council resolutions. Pakistan strongly rejects the Indian Ministry of External Affairs' attempt to deny responsibility for the elaborate and reprehensible global disinformation campaign against Pakistan exposed by EU Disinfo Lab. We believe that Indian Ministry of External Affairs' tall claims of India being a so-called responsible democracy have no legs to stand on. The latest developments and international exposes have clearly shown that India is neither responsible nor a democracy. Pakistan has already shared extensive and irrefutable evidence of India's active planning, promoting, aiding, abetting, financing, and executing terrorist activities in Pakistan. The report by EU Disinfo Lab further corroborates our long-standing position that India's incurable obsession with Pakistan and its unrelenting smear campaign against Pakistan. We urge the UN human rights machinery, particularly the UN Human Rights Council, to take a serious look as to how a prestigious platform such as HRC could be misused in such a manner against a member state. The relevant authorities in Switzerland and Belgium must investigate the finances and transparency of relevant NGOs registered within their respective jurisdictions. We also reiterate our call that the EU authorities take full cognizance of this massive disinformation campaign against Pakistan and initiate steps to hold accountable those who misuse their procedures and abuse the European institutions. Separately, Prime Minister Imran Khan had a telephone call with President of Afghanistan Ashraf Ghani to discuss progress in the ongoing Afghan peace process and strengthening of bilateral relations. The Prime Minister underlined that Pakistan's outreach to all Afghan stakeholders was part of its facilitative efforts to ensure progress towards an inclusive, broad-based, and comprehensive political settlement. The Prime Minister reiterated Pakistan's call to all Afghan sides to take measures for reduction in violence leading to a ceasefire. Earlier, a delegation of the Taliban Political Commission led by Mullah Abdul Ghani Brother arrived in Islamabad on 16th of December. During the visit, the delegation met with the Foreign Minister and also called on the Prime Minister of Pakistan. The visit of the Taliban Political Commission delegation is part of Pakistan's policy to reach out to all parties in the Afghan peace process with a view to facilitating the intra-Afghan negotiations. Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi is currently in the United Arab Emirates on an official visit. During the visit, the Foreign Minister held discussions with the UAE leadership on all areas of mutual interest, including regional and global issues. The Foreign Minister also met with the Pakistani diaspora. In his meeting with the Vice President and Prime Minister of the United Arab Emirates, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Makhdoom and his Emirati counterpart, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the Foreign Minister discussed ways to further strengthen cooperation between the two brotherly countries. The Foreign Minister also discussed matters pertaining to the welfare of Pakistani community living in the United Arab Emirates. Earlier, the sixth round of Foreign Secretary level bilateral political consultations between Pakistan and Sri Lanka was held virtually on 16th of December. A wide range of issues, including cooperation in the field of economy, trade and investment, health and education, defense and security, culture and tourism, people.
Islamabad mein tarjuman daftar ka